Close those eyes and lift up those hands. Open your mouth and say something to God. Baba wethu namandla siyabonga. My Jesus. Uyinkosi yenkazimulo uyaphila wethembekile. Izwi lakho linguwe. Izwi lakho lingukuphila. Baba wethu namandla. Oh, hallelujah. Kola manda masuka la mahandesia. We give you all the honor and the praise. Baba wethu namandla akekho njengawe. Egameni lika Jesu, even tonight, inhliziyo yethu is more than ready to receive from you. Baba wethu namandla siyabonga. Siyabonga moya oyingwele. Siyabonga bayete. Sinikeze indlebe kamoya ukuzwa kuvela kuwe. Baba wethu namandla onke siyabonga. What is impossible with man, it is possible with you. We pray that you may begin to move, begin to touch our hearts. Baba wethu namandla transform our minds with your word. Baba wethu namandla igama lakho ulenzela udumo. Baba wethu olungileyo, we bless your holy name in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Sibingelele bonke abakhonzi bakaNkulunkulu, RCC members. Sibingelele all pastors and their wives, organizers of all groups. Ngibingelele futhi ke ngokukhethekile abahlobo bami, Timba family. Siyambonga uNkulunkulu kakhulu ukuthi babe khona egameni leNkosi yethu Jesu. Family yakwaMagwaza from KZN, siyambonga uNkulunkulu kakhulu. Bonke abazalwane njengoba sebethuliwe. Glory to Jesus. Hallelujah. Ngicela ukuthi sizoqhubeka nale subject esigcine ngayo on our previous session. I want to emphasize this, bathandekayo. UNkulunkulu umoya oyingcwele ukuyi agenda yokwakhiwa kwebandla. I understand ukuthi sisenkonzweni yabantu abasha. Kodwa asikwazi ke ukuba singakukhulumi okuhlupha inhliziyo yethu. Umoya oyingcwele akubekayo. Amen. UNkulunkulu ubusiness yokwakhiwa kwebandla. If you can give me a little bit volume. As we all know, Uguti, God is a God of a pattern. Whenever he builds something, there is a pattern that must be followed. Beginning from the book of Genesis, especially chapter 1, verse number 26, let us make man, see a bigger pattern, according to our likeness. That was a pattern. Before that verse, yonke into unkulunkulu ebekade eyakha or a creator. There is a very important statement that follows each and every part of creation in each and every day. Maiketu unkulunkulu kwakha iBhayibheli ithi it was good. It was good. God created this and this, and it was good. Now, nalapha ke akha khona umuntu sibuka into ebalekile lapho ukuthi God was supposed to use a pattern in making man. Man was supposed to be made according to his image, according to his likeness. And also there is a purpose. Yokwakhiwa komuntu. Ithi purpose, let them have dominion. So siyabuka ke ukuthi God is a God of a pattern. Nezinto ke azidyalile ngaphezulu kwamagama athi uNkulunkulu uyawa appreciate wancoma. Kwela futhi when it comes to a process of reproduction of those things that were created. uNkulunkulu futhi uyayibeka ipattern. Angazi ngenze njani ukuphithizela kume. Because inetwork yami yalahleka. There was a process or a pattern in a process of reproduction. Uthi uNkulunkulu uma ke izinto zizozandisa lezi aseyidalile. Uthi they must produce after their own kind. That is very important. Now, njengoba ngithi uNkulunkulu ngomoya oyingcwele kule season ukuyibhizinisi enkulu yokwakhiwa kwebandla. God is restoring the pattern back to the church. Yeah. In such a way that abantu abasebenza bengekho mandated by God, they are going to be exposed. God does not call people and not give them a mandate. Whenever God anoints, he gives you a mandate. Lapha ekusebenzeni, ngiyeza lapha kwi youth bathani sakhuluma nebandla. Lapha ekusebenzeni kwabantu who are called. Kukhona ukubizwa. Kukhona ukulungiselelwa ubizo. Bese kuba khona ukuthunywa. Kuyenzeka ngisebenze ngingobiziwe kodwa ngingafinyelelile ekuthunyweni. Ngoba ngiyengeka iprocess of preparation where I must discover the mandate of my calling. uNkulunkulu ufika ambiza umuntu. Kufana ukuthi uma ngabe uNkulunkulu ukubizwa khona ukuthunywa. Ubiziwe. Kusho ukuthi ke yakulokubizayo. Uyozwa ukuthi ukubizelana uthini. Kuyenzeka ukuthi ngisebenze ngingobiziwe ngingeyena othunyiwe. Lani kunezindlebe kamoya.
Baninga bant, abasebenza ngobizo, bengathunyiwe. Leyonto yokusebenza nge-calling, ingenza ngisebenze ngingena direction, ngoba I'm not clear of the mandate.
Kola bashaka pasulaba.
Now is high time, bathandekayo. Singaphumputhi ekusebenzeni. Ngoba ngeke lakheke singayiphethe imandate.
Imandate asinikwa isonto. Futhi imandate nobizo asibizwa isonto. UNkulunkulu obizayo. Hallelujah. Okay, why am I speaking about this? Calling, preparation, sending. It's very important. When God calls, njengoba usukubiza ingane yakho zidlala eminyango. Jabulani. If igama lengane uJabulani. Jabulani, fandisabele. Bese iya kulo oyibizayo. Alibonke igama leNkosi. When you sense a calling, come closer to God. Hallelujah. And allow the process of preparation. Kula paya kwi preparation where unikwa khona I mandate. Yini okumele ngiyenze. Ufunda incwadi yezenzo, there is a very interesting thing here. We need to read carefully the book of Acts. Uma sizongena khaqa kwisizini umoya oyingcwele afaka kuyo ibandla. Ngangicabanga ukuthi icabangela njengosifiso kwaZulu, hayi njengosecretary weregion, hayi njengomfundisi, njengosifiso. Ukuthi mhlambe masibuya COVID kuzorestructurishwa. I was just thinking. Sithi evaluate ourselves. Kubizwe prayer conference. Lord, where to from now? Masikwazi operator as before COVID, after COVID. It was my thinking. Now, reading carefully the book of Acts, we possess an apostolic mindset concerning ukwakhiwa kwebandla. Alibonge igama lika Jesu. And we begin to view the church members according to the early church leaders. The way they view abapostoli, the way they view the members of the church, they viewed them as ministers, not as bench warmers. Abantu abathi mabesindisiwe sibe excited ukuthi hey sine sivuno izokwanda izishumi. No, babengenawo lowo mindset about the church members. They view them as ministers. Why am I saying that? Chapter 2, verse 42, no, chapter 8, verse 14 to 15. These two chapters or scriptures, they give you an apostolic mindset concerning the church members. Nokwakhiwa kwabo. Right. Uthi uverse number 42, chapter 2. Uma kudwa ukusindiswa kwalo 3,000 souls after Pentecost. Then, uverse 42, uthi, they devoted I like it in NIV. They devoted themselves to the apostles' doctrine. Amen. And sishiloke ukuthi leyo ndawo isivezela ukuthi abapostoli, they prioritize doctrine ekwakhiweni kwebandla. So, and kunento siyibona futhi lapho. Apostles were teaching devoted members. Ngamagama isibusiso esasikhona kwi church. The church members were willing students. And apostles were willing teachers. Angabi vice versa. Uthola ukuthi umfundisi wakho is packed ngezinto zakaNkuluNkulu. Ushoda ngama willing students. They were devoted. They devoted themselves. New convert, they devoted themselves. Babengaphushwa njengebhala. There was a willingness to learn. There was a willingness to grow in the things of the Lord. Willing believers or students need willing teachers when we are building the church. So, siyayithola ke lapho imindset ukuthi they view church members as ministers. That is why babephuthumisa ukuequipwa kwabo. Because at the end of the day, they must become ministers. Yezwakala bathandi kai? At the end of the day, they must become ungazi uphumela inkosi ungazange uministerishe. Lapha ku chapter 8 verse 14 and 15. Uma iphela imvuselelo kaPhilip eSamaria. Uthi verse number 14, now when the apostles who were at Jerusalem heard that Samaria had received the word of God, they sent Peter and John to them. Verse 15. Why they sent them? Who, when they had come down, prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Spirit. They sent Peter and John for the purpose of laying hands upon them so that this new convert, before bazofunda ezinye izinto, they must receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit. Ubazalwane. Ake siyeke bathandekayo ukuhlohla abantu ngento zesonto. Bengazazi kaNkuluNkulu. Uyazi kwezinye indawo, angiyeke le nto. Angiyeke. Right. What are we learning? Kule verse siqeda ukuyifunda. Ministries were recognized. They sent Peter and John. They were not sending person. They were sending ministries. Kufana nokuthandaza kwebandla lithandaza uPeter eboshiwe. Lalingakhulekela ukukhululwa kwaPeter, kwakuboshwa iministry. Kuyenzeka ibandla likhonze liboshelwa ama gifts and ministries. Up until we rise up and pray. Oh my God. Apostolic ministry was in jail. Laboni bandla ukuthi we cannot afford. Let us pray in one accord to release the ministry eboshiwe. Right, they sent Peter and John. Why? Because la apostolo kuthi ama ministries were recognized and they were used in a very systematic way in building the church and for kingdom advancement. Up until watandekayo we recognize gifts and ministries in our church, we must forget about the church growth and kingdom advancement. Asiqhubeke sonke. Kunento engeke yenzeke ebandleni up until ibandla likamoya recognize gift and ministries. So, we early church, our ministries, they were used in a very systematic way. Now, that is why I'm saying, babe ngathumeli uPeter noJohn, babe thumela a ministry that is fitting for the need. Can I repeat myself? They were not sending a band. They were sending a ministry that is fitting for the need. The church growth sizoyibona ngokuthi njengebandla la Assemblies of God, we must acknowledge our ministries, our gift, and begin to utilize them accordingly. Accordingly. Ephesians 4:11, as we all know, ministry gifts are listed there. And iyabekwa ipurpose ku verse 12. Once our ministries are recognized, asebenziswa in a systematic way, in a biblical order, we are going to see the process of equipping of the saints. Amen. Till we all come to the unity of faith. Actually, that is our core business. The core business of the church is Ephesians chapter 4. It must become the order of the day. Ephesians chapter 4. From verse 1 up until verse number 16. That book must be brought back to the church and become practical. Now, for the equipping of the saints, ngamama gama ayenzeki equipping ebandleni where there is no operation of the fivefold ministry. Cela ukubona izandla zenu bathandika. Ayenzeki equipping of the saints if these ascension gift or ministries are not in full operation. Glory to God. So again, we will see the equipping of the saints. We'll see the growth of the church. Likula kwi character ka Christ. Njengoba Paul esho ethi nginemihelo nginenimba ngane Galatia. Up until Christ is formed in you. The operation ye fivefold ministry iqedwe umntwana, iqedwe infant. Singabe sisaba zingane. Sishukunyusa okwamaza. Ilenza ibandla libe bukhali in understanding the scriptures and also to detect error and heresy. Ngeke udlale ngebandla eli indoctrinated. You see, ibandla uma ngabe linga equipiwe lidlala abantu. Badlale ngalo. Bali manipulate, balenze yonke lento ongayicabanga because the church is not grounded kuma scriptures. Engathi besingaba nomoya we local assembly ase Pereya. Ibandla elane appetite nge sound doctrine. Elalinge nandaba ne charisma yomshumayeli. Elalimlalela likubuke konke akwenzayo bese liyohlola ukuthi lento ayishoyo is it in harmony with the scriptures. It's high time ukuthi singabanjwa ubu vibrant nobu charismatic bomshumayeli silibale izinto azishoyo ukuthi is it in line with the doctrine of the scriptures. They were able to balance things. Albon Kamalga Ches. Babe was Ugu check abazi ba check and Chumayelo Paul. Egum postole njalo fanele bamhlole naye. Hallelujah. Yes. Ukuthi lento ayishoyo is it in harmony with kuyenzeka umuntu ashumayele the scriptures kodwa kungabi yizwi lenkosi, the word of God. Avuli Bible ashumayela, but not the word of God. Angalama ngezwakala bathandekayo. Ngingaba nentshumayela emnandi.